If you're a bad girl, get at me, bad girl. Work me, baby. Shaking it the way I like. I'm ready to be. Good morning. Today's video is going to be very different than anything else I did on my channel. Today's topic is boss babe business tips. I wrote all my notes down, and that's what I'm going to tell you guys today. So I gave 10 different tips. I feel like these are the most important 10 tips, whether you're starting a cosmetic brand, a hair company, nails, or just any other entrepreneuring business, especially online. But you can kind of use all these tips elsewhere as well. So the first tip is securing the bag. Securing the bag, what does that mean? Stacking your money, saving your money, finding your passion, and do just that. So my passion has always been makeup for the past 5-6 years, I believe. So what I did was, in 2018, I took that and it went up a step further, and I started A Creations, my own small business. Now, securing the bag, that includes saving up money, which me, those who personally know me, no, I never was able to save, period. Never, ever, ever. But then once I knew that I had to save money for my vacation that just happened, I was like, what? I need to save money. Like, there's no other option. So what I did was, every so often, I would put some money in my dresser that I know I never really went into, and that's how I was able to save that money. I've touched it a few times, I'm not gonna lie, but I still was able to save about $900 from February all the way to June, right before my vacation. Now, like I said, I've touched it a few times, so without me touching it, I probably would have saved way more. But being that I did touch it for things that I needed, my hair, etc., I'm actually blessed to be able to say I was able to save that much money within that amount of time. Now, also, I got a few orders sometimes with like $100 or whatever, and I would take maybe $75 or sometimes that full $100 if I knew I did not need it, and I put it into that saving. Okay, so the next tip is promote. I cannot stress that enough. I promote constantly on all my social media, my Facebook, I go live, Instagram, go live. All that is promotion. Snapchat, I post constantly, always doing my full face with only my products aside from foundation, mascara, and all that. That is promotion. Everything you need to promote. You're not gonna get clientele out there if you're not promoting. Like, how is that gonna work? Promotion. Doing YouTube videos alone is promoting your products. Promote, promote, promote. I cannot stress that enough. Make sure you promote, because if you're not gonna promote, ain't nobody else gonna promote for you, period. And I'm going to speak about promotion on later on. Okay, so make all social media accounts, period. You never know who's going to be following you on Twitter that might not be following you on Instagram. Promote. Make all the social media accounts possible. Facebook. You may have family and friends on Facebook that's not going to follow you on Instagram or Twitter because they don't have that. And those family and friends could be purchasing from you or telling their family and friends, etc., etc. Make all social media accounts. You never know. A lot of people's like, oh, I don't want Facebook. But Facebook is where I get most of my customers, to be honest. And not only that, there's a bunch of makeup groups on Facebook that you're not going to find on Instagram. Make all social media accounts. I never really use Twitter, and I still don't really know how to use Twitter as much. But I made one. And people retweet my tweets all the time, and I retweet other people's tweets, so you never know. Now, all these tips are very important, but this is also another important tip. It's tip number 4, which is go to pop-up shops, beauty events. Now, what I mean by that is, say one of your fellow business owners or business friends live in the same city as you, and they're doing a pop-up shop. Yes, granted, you might not have a big table like they are because of whatever, but you can also go to that event, hand out your business cards, bring some of your products with you. And like, you can definitely promote that way as well. And honestly, all these tips kind of intertwine to one another. Now, from my experience, I went to BeautyCon. BeautyCon, for those of you that don't know, is a very big makeup event. They have one in New York City, which obviously I live in. That's the one I went to. I've been to BeautyCon 3 years already. And this year was their 5th year anniversary. This year, Cardi B was there. Rick Ross was there. A bunch of other people were there as well. Now, to get on topic or whatever. First of all, Cardi B, shout out to you. Highly doubt she'll ever watch this video, but whatever. She did a whole panel about securing the bag, talking about making money moves, all that. Like, she was just speaking facts, period. If you missed that event, you missed out on a good one. Sorry. But anyways, so I went to BeautyCon this year, and this is the first year that I started A Creations at a beauty event. With that being said, although I did not have my business cards with me, which I felt like I should have, but it was okay. I met some 3 girls that came from South Carolina, I believe, that we were all at the panel, the morning panel on Sunday together. We just started talking. I don't know how the conversation started. And I just happened to have some of my products with me, which is very rare. Like, I don't really carry around my products, but I did happen to have some of my products with me, and we were talking about it. I think I might have had my makeup done, or I don't know how it started. And with that being said, that day, that Sunday, out of the 3 girls, I made $100. Now, they wanted some of my palettes. I showed them my palettes and other products that I did not have with me. And they was like, well, we're leaving on Monday. Is there any way that you can kind of meet up with us in the city in the morning to get all these other products, because I want them before I leave? And I'm like, you know what? I can definitely do that. I will do that. And I met up with them on 34th Street and made another $100. Look at that. Went to BeautyCon and made $200 in basically one day with one event. That's more than I even spent to even go to BeautyCon. You never know. And now, with that being said, I also gave out my Instagram throughout the whole event. And I got other people's Instagrams as well. And with that, I've gotten a bunch of clientele, returning customers from BeautyCon. Shout out to y'all if y'all ever watched this video. So that's why I say make sure you go to all the pop-up shops. Obviously, if they're $100, $200, you might not be able to afford every single one. But those that are $10, $15, definitely get your tickets to go. You never know who you may meet. You may meet your business bestie and y'all become millionaires together. You never know. Make sure you go to pop-up shops as much as possible. You might, down the line, be able to make your own pop-up shop and be a vendor at your own pop-up shop just by going to small pop-up shops and seeing how they work. So I definitely recommend doing that. I haven't went to one yet, but I'm definitely going to a good friend of mine. Her name is Beauty by Brie. Make sure you go subscribe to her channel, Brie Walker, and her Instagram and stuff. She's having a pop-up shop in New York City. The link is in her bio, and I definitely will be attending that. I might not be able to be a vendor, which I'm still trying to work on, but I'm definitely going to go to support her and also network for myself. Now, with that being said, like I said, all these tips kind of intertwine. Another tip that I feel is most important is to hand out your business cards. You never know who may be potential customers. My last day of school, I went around the school and I handed out business cards. Granted, I might not have gotten sales from that, but you never know. Number 6, do giveaways. Giveaways, giveaways, giveaways. Granted, some people might not like to give out free products, and I understand that. But with giveaways, you never know. Same thing that I've said with everything else. You literally never know who's going to be your next customer. That customer may bring you thousands of customers. You never know. With that being said, some of my giveaways... Okay, so for one instance, my Mother's Day giveaway, I did 2 winners. Originally, it was only 1, but I gotten so many people to join, so I did 2 winners. My first winner happens to be a girl that I went to high school with, and once she got all the products, she posted a video, a whole video of all the products she got, and a bunch of mutual friends that I feel like might have not purchased without her giving her review, purchased a few bonnets for me. A few of the friends purchased different bonnets for me. And that was like amazing. With that also being said, she's a makeup artist. And she wound up doing my makeup for free for graduation, being that she won my giveaway. So you just never know. Now, promoters. Like I said, this is number 7. Like I said, I was going to get back on this. Promoters. A lot of small business owners use promoters and some also don't. I've had various experiences with promoters. You guys are wondering what lip gloss I'm wearing. It's Cherry Kiss. Mm-hmm. Bomb. Period. Anyway, well, you know what? Hold on. Back to giveaways and stuff. This Cherry Kiss lip gloss was very underrated. This is actually the original formula that I'm using. I actually added some gold glitter after, and this looks very wear and tear. If that makes any sense. This is my old formula. I actually added, like I said, more glitter. Well, actually added glitter because I did not have glitter. So I added some gold glitter. This is just, it's by itself without the gold glitter. And it looked bomb with the gold glitter. Like, my new formula looks bomb as well. Just saying, period, poo. Okay, so basically, one of my good business friends, her name is Jazzed Up Cosmetics. Make sure you go follow her on Instagram as well. She won one of my giveaways. She won, I believe, a gold eyeliner, the Cherry Kiss lip gloss, and the Now Angel lashes, and also Princess Lashes, which now is Majesty, I believe. Yeah. She won all those products during one of my giveaways. She did 2 lash watches, which bomb. And the most important thing she did was, the thing that I'm so grateful for, was my Cherry Kiss lip gloss swatch. Prior to her doing those swatches, that lip gloss was so underrated. I really didn't get any customers behind that. After her doing the lip gloss swatches, bro, period. When I say she brought me so many clients, it wasn't specifically on her end where, like, I got clients from her followers, but it was that she was able to send me those pictures and I was able to post those pictures. And what? When I say I got so many clients from that, so many clients from that. That lip gloss is one of my top selling lip glosses within the last 2 months. It's been selling faster than Glowing has, to be honest. But whatever. So promoters, what I say about that is, it's kind of weary. I've had a good experience and I've had bad experience. My 2 lip gloss promoters, bomb. They post every so often, and I've gotten, like, they've gotten, been consistent with posting to an extent. One of them is really good with posting, and she happened to be a customer of mine prior to me choosing her as my lip gloss promoter, and she's bomb. Shout out to you, Karen, if you watch this. Now, my palette promoters. What can I say about them? I gave out 3 free palettes back in March. One of the girls did really good, and then we kind of had a disagreement or miscommunication, I should say. And I don't know, but like, she was really good. She posted all the time. I'm so thankful for her. Now, one of the others, she's been doing looks more frequent now, so I'm super hyped about that. She even did a few YouTube videos, so I'm excited about that. Shout out to you, Jasmine. Now, another promoter, she did maybe 2 looks, and I gave her my palette February, March, and we're in July, and that's it. Like, I messaged her. I'm not trying to shame anyone, to be honest. I'm just saying my experience based off how these promoters worked for me. She did the 2 looks or 3 looks, and that was that. If you're going to promote, especially for my brand or any small business brand, we expect you to promote a bunch of times. Like, a few times a week if possible, a few times a month. Not 2-3 times in 4 or 5 months, especially if we're giving you a free eyeshadow palette. You go to Sephora, and the cheapest palette you get there is $30. Period. And that's a little Huda Beauty for 9 pans. Just saying. You will go to Sephora and pay $40 to $50 for a palette, and we're giving you a whole palette for free. And when I say, like, I have a palette in front of me, let me show you how pigmented my palettes are. Like, they're so underrated and slept on. Look at that. And this is my Jump Into Summertime palette. Let me show you some of the swatches. Even this yellow is pigmented. What? So hard to get a yellow that's pigmented. These are just a few colors. Y'all see that pigment? Look at that. Boom. And that's all my palettes. And I'm not just saying that because those are my palettes. I'm saying that because it's facts on facts on facts. Period, poo. Anyways, so that's that. Now, my lash promoter. I had one girl for lashes. I gave her Drama Queen. She did a whole video on it, or two videos. She posted a few times. I was thankful for that, but then she unfollowed me. What? I was confused. So I messaged her about it. I was like, hey, love, did you unfollow me? And no answer. Okay. I give you a whole pair of lashes for free, and this is how you do me? Okay, sis. Cool. No love lost. And it's crazy because one of my business friends actually warned me about this person, and that was after I gave her my lashes, and I was so confused. But whatever, you live and you learn. And this is why, if you want to become my palette promoter, you guys see why I changed all my rules. With that being said, if you want to be my palette promoter, message me. You have to have over 1,000 followers on Instagram, and you will get 50% off one palette. You see why now. Anyways, now, oh my god, tip number 8. Well, you know what, going back to 7, not saying that you should not give out palettes, not saying you should not give out lashes, not saying you should not give out lip glosses or whatever else you sell, because I've had some good promoters, very good promoters, but this is just my experience with my promoters. That does not mean I'm gonna stop finding promoters, because you never know, I might find one of the best promoters. I'm gonna continue grinding and continue searching. I found this one girl, and she got my stuff only a few weeks ago, not even like 2-3 weeks ago, and she's used my brow pomade. She's like obsessed with it, used it for every single look since she's got it. Shout out to her. That's a promoter, period, poo. All right, anyways, now tip number 8, be consistent on YouTube. When I say this, I literally mean it. Literally mean it. I experienced that back in January, February, March, somewhere around those months. I used to do videos all the time. Before I would go to school, I would film my makeup look, etc. And I used to get so many views behind that. So many views. One of my videos got 500 views. What? That's amazing. Especially just starting out. So then I actually had to stop, and one of my previous videos actually explains why I stopped. Now, me trying to get back onto YouTube, having even gotten more than 80 views. This is why I say be consistent. If I would have realized this would have happened, I would have continued doing videos. Whether or not I had to do it once a week, I would have continued, because I'm gonna leave that right there. Now, tip number 9, word of mouth. Word of mouth helps so much. Oh my god, oh my god, word of mouth, period. So now, she's now a friend. She explained to one of her friends about my products, and the girl was like, oh my god, I want to try it. She hit me up at midnight. And those of you that know me know that, how you say it, I wake up every day between the hours of 1 and 4. This, honestly, I don't know the reason behind it, but it's been this way ever since my Titi passed away. I'm not gonna hold you. So for the past year and a half, every day between 1 and 4, I would wake up. Only one time between this year and a half that I did not wake up, and that was because I was with my best friend. I can't explain it. I don't know how to explain it. I don't know why it's happening, but this is literally what's going on in my life. It's been this way for a year and a half now. I'm used to it. Anyways, so she hit me up and she was like, oh, I want to try out your products. So-and-so told me about them and I want to give them a shot. Okay, I fell back to sleep. The next morning, she hit me up again. Can I see this, this, and that? I said, okay. Showed her my products, everything. This girl, no lie, don't know me from a hole in the wall, but because of word of mouth, spent $100. Look at that. And she loved my products. Now, tip number 10. Don't give up ever, no matter what, period. We all go through them stages where we feel like it's pointless. We go through them stages where we feel like we're not getting customers. We go through them stages where we feel like just giving up, right? We all do that. I go through that. But don't give up. Remember why you started your brand. Remember why you started your YouTube. Remember why you started being a Instagram influencer. Don't give up. Just pray. At the end of the day, God is gonna make it. He's gonna make it for all of us. He's gonna make sure we all eat, we all make it big. Period. Period. He's gonna work his magic. Trust and believe when I say this. Trust me. It's happened to me. Believe that. Just constantly pray. And when you make it big, make sure you don't forget to thank him for working his magic. You feel me? Don't ever give up. I explained in one of my videos why I started, and when I feel like giving up, a flashback comes in my head. Aaliyah, you cannot stop. You gotta make your angels proud. Period. No matter what. Period. Like, period, poo. So, that being said, I hope you guys take my tips, use them within your own brand, and make sure to subscribe. Leave a thumbs up, put on your post notifications, comment below some suggested videos you suggest me on doing. And if you like my products, if you like my palette that I just showed, I currently only have a few left in stock until my next restock. Make sure to go in the description box, go on my website, and purchase that. Thanks, Pooh. Thank you guys so much for watching. Stay tuned for the next video. Bye. I was born a flex. Yes. Diamonds on my neck. I like boarding jets. I like morning sex. But nothing in this world that I like more than checks. Money. All I really wanna see is the money.